Still juggling and shit.
Ooh, hop in that motherfucking phone. And that motherfucker be wrong. Big gun beat, yeah, Sean. City to city, I'm torn. Lacardi, I'm ready to pour. I love my diamond, that gone. Fuck with your bitch, yeah, she left in the morning. Diamonds that skating on ice. Run it up, bitch, Jerry Rice. Hurt your feelings with the price. Everything come with a price. Everything come with a price.
Y'all thought I was serious? Y'all thought that title was serious? Nigga, Jared Little Joker is garbage. He ain't even close to being the best Joker. That nigga got tattoos on his face, thinking, oh, I put tattoos on my face, I'm automatically tough. Stop. He got a grill in his mouth. Whoa. You a rapper, bruh? You a rapper now, Joker? What's your SoundCloud, homie? Miss me. In that whack laugh. Yeah.
I can tell you meant that.
Yeah.
You suck!
That laugh is garbage, bro. That's not even a laugh. That's the most unnatural laugh I've ever heard a day in my life. Yeah. How are that whack shit goes? But this ain't the video. Look. So, the man, the myth, the legend himself, the epic, the ultimate, the whole beacon of what it means to hold on to a cut for 4 years and not see its release. Zack motherfucking Snyder.
Fucking commit any atrocities. I'm like, that's cool, but you're living in a fucking dream world, okay? So.
What?
Now, Zack Snyder had some ideas for the DCEU. Now, let me get this straight. I like 300. I like Dawn of the Dead. I like Watchmen. That's it. Snyder has other films. I seen them. I don't care for them. And you can count BVS as one of his films. You can count Man of Steel as one of his films because he directed those films. I can care less. This is how it is. You got me trying to, look, watch Watchmen. Shits on Man of Steel and BVS off top. Man of Steel, very... Oh, alien comes to another planet and society is trying to Superman's trying to understand why the world is like this and he's an alien, he's foreign to the world and stuff and blah, blah, blah. I mean, okay, you know, whatever. I've seen a lot of superhero, you know, stories to know what kind of plot Snyder was trying to go with. Alien, refugee, another planet. The world sees him as a monster, but he's actually in reality here to help us. But we humans, we are judgmental, yada yada. You know, the normal shit. Like, bro, we get it. Humans are judgmental. Humans see somebody who's a different skin color. You're yellow?
Unacceptable!
Beach? You know how humans get. But Zack Snyder did a watch party. Now, I didn't want to watch this watch party because, in my opinion, I don't want to watch it anyways. That's just 3 hours long, and it's just him. I watched the first couple minutes, and oh man, he brought his book. It's called The Book. His thing said The Book on it, or Book, with his storyboards and stuff, and I was like, oh shit, fuck. Here we go again. Guess what he's going to do? I wouldn't be surprised if he was talking about his Snyder Cut and what he would have wanted and yada 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 in there, but look, Snyder, I understand how you feel. Warner Brothers, y'all ain't shit either for how y'all did Snyder. But Snyder, look, Snyder fans, look. Granted, he didn't get to release his Snyder Cut, but just looking all based off Man of Steel and BVS, I'd say Snyder didn't deserve to release the Justice League Cut, his Snyder Cut. what was it gonna do to fix what happened in BVS and Man of Steel? That garbage. Like, Snyder created a film of Superman where it... Snyder failed the little small details of Superman, right? Let me just talk about this. If you can't even get these noticeable little details right, how am I supposed to get the bigger picture? How are you supposed to get the bigger picture right? Because you can't even get the little details that shouldn't even be messed up. And don't make sense. For example, let's jump to BVS. Superman inhaled kryptonite gas and didn't die. Mind you, Superman got shot by a kryptonite bullet before.
That's good. We're ready for you now.
I have it.
And, you know, various stories. It's mainly the story where Batman's whole contingency plan to basically subdue the Justice League if they ever got out of hand was totally flipped, and the villains used it against him and shot Superman with a kryptonite bullet, then yes. But kryptonite, mind you, BVS is the first time Superman in this universe was exposed to kryptonite. So this rock that is known to harm his species and literally weaken and almost kill them if they were to get close to it. Mind you, if he gets close to it, he's gonna be on the ground like, ooh. If he inhales a gas that goes into his lungs, come on, guys. The gas is supposed to kill him. I mean, the reason the bullet didn't kill him was that it wasn't that close to his heart to where it could have killed him, but it put him in a critical position to where he could have died. In Martian Manhunter, I think he had to take his, he had to liquefy himself to pull out the bullet and jump inside Superman's body, if I remember. But, come on. Come on now. You tell me Superman inhales kryptonite gas and he lives? Okay, Snyder. If you knew who Superman was, Superman cannot survive that. He should be dead. I'm just saying. He should be dead, or he should be in the hospital going... Kryptonite in his system all effing up his head and shit. You know what I mean. But he got hit by the gas 2 times, recovered, and was still alive. Damn. And then we go to Man of Steel. Granted, Man of Steel is a very good film if you look at it as an alien from another planet coming to our world. If you really just factor out the fact that he's not... Gotta really look at it as it's a guy that's like Superman, but he's not Superman, and you'll really love the movie. But it's a Superman movie, so I can't really look at it as not a Superman movie. This nigga Snyder created the worst father and son dynamic I have seen in a long time. He created a father in Jonathan Kent, who is also the beacon to what Superman is in his life. You know, Superman is heavily shaped by Jonathan and Martha Kent and their ideals too. You're telling me this dude's dad scolds his son, who has the powers to do impossible things that we humans wish we can do to help people. He scolds his son for saving his fellow classmates on a school bus. Mind you, yes, his identity could have been exposed, but he did it for good. His dad was like, oh, maybe you should have let them, or maybe not. Maybe you shouldn't have saved them. Maybe you should have. Maybe you should be. This is how I would that John DeKent scene should have been. He should have went like, son, very glad you use your abilities to help those kids, because if I was in your position, I would have done the same thing too. And then he kind of educated him like, now what you could have done, because they still asking questions. What you could have done was you could have used your super speed, you know, because I saw you running. You move pretty quick. You could have used your super speed better to, you know, not be seen. But next time, son, if you're going to help people, factor in your super speed and use that to your advantage to not be seen. Because still, this world is not ready for someone like you. But that does not mean you cannot help. You can help for now in silence, but you can still help. He basically scolded his son for acting on doing something good. What type of father in Superman's life is that? Superman's father should be complimenting his son and giving him props for doing the right thing, using the power that we all of us wish we can have to help people to help people. And then he's like, maybe you should have left tonight. Maybe you should have. I don't know. There is no I don't know. It's either you did a good job, son, or you should have done that, son. Be straight up. I don't know. So, Jonathan, if you was in that position, you had powers, you would have just let them die? I mean, shoot, that would have been more suspicious for you to be the only one that lives. That would have been more suspicious for Clark to be the only one that survives and all the other people die in the bus and drown, but Clark is the only one that lives. That looks even more suspicious. You're telling me Clark was the only one that knew how to swim and get out of it? Come on now. It would have been suspicious regardless. Clark's the only kid that would have survived anyways. You know how many parents going to get paranoid and question, like, why was Clark the only one that survived but all our other kids died? My son knows how to swim. Why was Clark the only one that lived? That's going to be even more suspicious. So it was either he doesn't help or he don't help. Either way, he's going to get questioned. Like, you know, this is going to cause suspicion. And then Snyder creates it to where Jonathan Kent, and this is why I call him a trash father and a trash person in general. Jonathan Kent, mind you, Superman figured out he had heat vision in elementary school. Mind you, heat vision. The ability to shoot a source of heat from your eyes. And he can control how hard the blast is going to hit, and he can control it. He can minimize it. He can expand his heat vision. He can do a lot with that. There's a lot of stuff that goes into that heat vision. You tell me Superman, as a child, develops his heat vision.
Clark, come out of there.
Leave me alone.
Clark, I have called your mother. Clark!
But you're telling me he would not, mind you, if he found out he had heat vision, he would have found out he had super speed. How long does it take for him to figure out he got super speed? All he has to do is run. And he's a kid. Kids are adventurous. Kids are going to go and test their abilities and push them to the max. That's what kids do. Kids feel invincible. Superman was a kid on the farm. I used to stay on the farm. I used to go and do whatever I wanted around my parents' farm. Trust me. If I can see it, I'm going to go do it. That's how I was. All this big open space and you expect me not to go wild as a kid? Come on now. Tell me Superman was not on that farm by himself, like, playing with his powers and stuff? Come on now, guys. All he had to do is it literally probably took him one day to figure out he can run fast. So, Superman and his father, that whole tornado sequence, his dad is staring there at a tornado like, no, son, no, don't help me. Don't help daddy. And then Clark's like, okay.
What?
Nigga, you can save your daddy. Run your ass over there. And I don't want to hear nobody talking about, but he was going to expose his identity. How can Superman expose his identity when nobody can't see him run? He moves faster than the human eye can see. The human eye. I looked like there was all humans at that overpass where Superman was at. Him saving his dad would have been done in literally seconds, and everybody would have just been confused because they wouldn't know what happened. They wouldn't know what to say. Because everything happens so fast, they can't have time to really come to a conclusion about anything. Because they'll be confused. And besides that, that tornado was there, so that also throws away their attention. Then have them focus on that big-ass tornado that's sucking up their cars and stuff and destroying shit around it. You think all those people was focused on little Jonathan? When you got that big-anus tornado sucking up everybody's cars and causing all this damage around them, Come on now. You tell me Superman as a teen was not going to try and decide, hey, you know, maybe there's a way I can, you know, stop the tornado or something. I don't know. Like, hero up, bruh. Do some shit. Hiding your powers. What type of plot is this? And then Jonathan Kent, this trash father, is going to sit there and let himself die in front of his wife and his son. He's going to commit suicide in front of his family. That's like a dad literally hanging himself in his own house. And as soon as his wife and kids walk into the house, they see their dad hanging. Like, what the freak? Why would you do your kids like that? Why would you do your family like that? That's effed up. You're trying to traumatize your family? What type of father is that? What type of family member is that? Like, don't look. For most part, a lot of people who may kill themselves won't do it near their family because they don't want them to see that. They rather somebody else, you know, that's not a friend of the family see it. Like some random person they met. Or just do it somewhere randomly, but not let the family see it. They don't want to traumatize their family. Yes, they'll be traumatized after, but they won't really see the graphicness of what you did to yourself. But Superman just stands there like a wax sun. If I was in Superman position, I would have ran over there, grabbed my dad, got my dog, whoosh, ran back over, and went like, "Hi, everybody! What's up?" But like I say, Jared Leto Joker, he's the best Joker. April Fools, got your ass. Jared Leto Joker is not the best Joker. That's what I'm going to say. But I'm going to go in this video. It's your boy, Kid Out, the first black Super Saiyan, whoever riding his plank goes to that. Peace, love, positivity, all that jazz. Don't do drugs. Deuces.